I feel so weird filming this while my roommate is still home. Hey guys, it's Jenna, otherwise known as Undyne on Virtual Popstar, and today we're going to be doing a Get Ready With Me video. Now, it is 5:30 in the afternoon and the sun is probably going to be going down soon, but I figured why not shoot a video while the sun is still up? So we're going to try to knock this one out. So it is the first day of spring, so I thought why not do a spring sort of tutorial, you know? I'm just gonna kind of show you my everyday makeup. It does change every day what I do, but we're just gonna do a full face. We're just gonna do some spring looks. This is as close as I can get. I don't have like a setup. I'm kind of just using my phone, so sorry if you can't really see what I'm doing. I'm gonna be looking into a mirror the entire time, so well, let's hope this comes out good. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you're not already, please subscribe and like the video down below. But one quick note before we get started. If you'd like to join the YouTube team, we are accepting applications now until, I believe, April 1st. If that's something you're interested in doing, like making videos like this or editing videos together for the website, just apply. I'll put the link down in the description box below. All right, we're gonna get started. So first, I use this NYX Photo Loving Primer. I absolutely love this stuff. It's cheaper than most primers, but it's still like very, very good. What I do is just put a little bit on my finger in different spots around my face, and this is the only time I use my finger, but I just rub them in. Beautiful. Next, I take the Tarte Amazonian Clay Full Coverage Foundation, and this stuff is literally my life. I think all the products I'm going to be using today are cruelty-free, and Tarte is cruelty-free, but their parent company tests on animals, and I've been trying to find kind of substitutes for that eventually, but since I haven't found anything yet, I still use this. So I think NYX is their parent company, also tests on animals, but they're cruelty free, so it just depends on how you view that. I don't view that as like actually testing on animals, but I've been trying to start getting only strictly cruelty free companies. Now I'm just gonna use Tarte, and I really like this one because it is full coverage and it gets everywhere. And just take a damp beauty blender. I know mine is absolutely atrocious. I haven't really washed it in like a week and a half, but we're just gonna take that. And I like to squirt this stuff out onto my hand. Less than I think I'll need, because I end up just using that and it's the perfect amount, because I always tend to think more is better. And then I'm just gonna take a little bit of that and I'm just gonna start dabbing in small sections. Sometimes if it's feeling like patchy like it is right now, I do tend to go over just with like a really thin second coat, just so that it really like seals it in and makes it look more smooth and all around not ugly. If you guys are wondering, this is my natural hair. I just got out of the shower, so after I've mostly applied foundation everywhere, I'll just go in with this NYX Studio Photogenic Concealer Stick. It's about 2 shades lighter than my normal skin, but it doesn't look very much lighter. And I will just place this on normal spots where you usually highlight, so under the eyes, the T area, and then my chin. Then sometimes I just go over blemishes too. Now that I did that, I'm just gonna dab it out. And I think I'm gonna go grab something really quick to put my hair away from my face, so be right back. I'm back. I'm going to take this NYX finishing powder and I'm just gonna put this right where I concealed everywhere. It's not really baking powder, but I use it as that because it's very easily crushed because it's pressed. But yeah, We're gonna do that. And then I'm just gonna go in everywhere with this hashtag no filter finishing powder, which is more of a basic skin. Cool, it just broke all over my bed. Now don't worry, I do come back and contour my face at the end, so this is not the finished foundation look, because if it was, I would look like an egg. Next up is my brows, and my brows tend to get very hairy really quickly, so I usually take like this, it's a little eyebrow razor, and I sort of like, you know, like get all the little hairs out before I do my brows. And this is every day because they grow back way fast. Next, I just go in with this e.l.f. It is like a little dip brow thing. It works pretty well for me. e.l.f. is really cheap and sometimes their quality is not the best, but I like this stuff, so I use it. Also, I don't use very much eyebrow product, because as you can see, I have really good eyebrows normally. But this just helps shape them, I guess. After all the gaps are filled, I like to just brush through them a couple times with a little spoolie. Sorry if the view shifted, I just had to check if it was still filming, which it is, so that's good. Next, I take this Ulta Nude Matte Eyeshadow Primer. I don't know if it's zooming in or not, I hope so. But this was the sample size I got, and I really like it, so I bought a whole big bottle, so once this is out, I can still use it, because I never really buy eyeshadow primer. Like, I've always had this one for like a really long time, longer than I should have. But it wasn't very good, so I just wouldn't use it. But this stuff is like heaven. You just gotta take a little bit like that under your brush and then just put it on your eyelid. So I blended that out, and now I'm actually gonna use this palette for, the first thing. And the first thing, I just take this Color Free Spirit. Sorry if there was a glare from the sun, I literally just realized it's right there. But I just put this all over my lid so that everything else will blend. This is the only thing I use from this palette anymore, and I'll explain that in a second. Now, I don't use this palette really anymore. I'm gonna try to cover for the glare, but I just don't. I enjoy the colors, but most of them I never used. As you can tell, some of them are still fresh, but it would just crease really easily, and I was a big fan of it for a while, and then I got a new palette, which I'm gonna be using today, and that palette is so much better, and it never creases, and I was like, why was I without this palette to begin with, you know? And what's that palette, you ask? The one everyone obsesses over. It's true, like, it's so good. Like, I'm not usually one to go with trends very often, but this palette is a must, and it's so cheap compared to like the quality of it. Like, I feel like it should be more expensive than it actually is because it's such good quality, and I've just never had anything like it. And if you've never seen it, I don't want to glare you, but that's what it looks like. It's beautiful, and it's the best. So I just take a standard like blending brush thing. I'm gonna make this more of like a pinky, like spring color. So we're gonna first go in with Buon Fresco right there. We're gonna go in with Buon Fresco just like right on the crease area, and not very much of it at all. I'm going to go in with a little bit of Love Letter on the crease again, just to deepen it a little bit more. The best thing about this palette is it's so pigmented that you do not need a lot of product at all. Like, this was a very small amount, and it's blending out perfectly. Less is more. Now, if I do too much like I did with this eye, I just kind of blend it out until it's no more. I'm gonna go in with a little bit of Venetian red, and it's a little bit more shimmery, but it's still not shimmery where it's gonna like show that it's shimmery. And I just put a littlest amount in my crease. And then I'm gonna go in with the littlest amount of Cyrus Umber into my crease, and that's that one. The sun just got brighter, I think. And finally, to make this all kind of come together, we're gonna take red ochre and put that on the outer corner area. Just grab a different brush, and I'm gonna go in with Primavera, which is like a gold shimmer, and put that all over my eyelid. I will go in with it's the best liquid liner ever, Wet n Wild. This is the best. I have never found a better eyeliner. This one's only like $3 at the drugstore, as opposed to like $20 eyeliners or any other liquid liner. This is the best. I swear by it. I buy like so many at once because like I don't want it to get discontinued. Now when doing my eyeliner, I take as much product off as I can and try to go in small streaks, just very, very slowly. I hope I'm in a good angle, you know? I hope you guys can actually see what I'm doing. And then I like to set my eyeliner sometimes with just any black eyeshadow that you have. I just set it with black eyeshadow because it makes it like stay, but this stuff I really don't need to set it, but other products I have, sometimes it just makes it look more matte, you know? And I know this eye is looking a little rough right now. Usually I would take a Q-tip and kind of clean up the edges, but I ran out of Q-tips, so I'm just gonna let it slide. After I do that, I just go in with kind of a white eye pencil by NYX, and I just put it like on my lower lash line to like make the colors pop a little bit. And after doing that, I'll just go back in with one of the other eyeshadow shades and put it lower than my lash line. I'm just gonna go in with Love Letter and put it on the very bottom part. You'll see. And now it's time for some mascara. This is just a Tarte one that I have. My favorite is probably Too Faced. One of theirs, I forget what it's called. I just got this for Christmas a few months ago, so I've been using it up a lot. I'm gonna go in with this a few times. Usually I don't wear fake lashes. It's very rare that I do, and also I'm out of them at the moment, so I couldn't show you if I wanted to, but they just kind of bother me, so I usually just do mascara and try to make my eyelashes look longer. Sitting and it's in a really weird place right now, and I feel like I'm being whited out. Oh my gosh. And then after I go over mascara once, I'll just briefly go over again so that I don't have to like, I don't know, I feel like that just makes them pop just a little bit more. Next, I'm gonna go in with this Coco Contour palette. I've used this for a while. And it comes kind of like that. I just use a mix of both shades now. I used to just use the lighter shade, but that was during the winter when it was like, I was really pale, but now I'm like getting a little bit more tan, so we're gonna use both of them. I'm sorry if it looks really bad on camera. I'm not very good at this, I don't think, but I'll wing it. We'll see if it looks good or not. I just put it on like the whatever it's called, your cheek, under my chin, and then kind of on my forehead just a little bit. And then sometimes I do my nose, but not always, but I'll try to do it for this video. I'm really bad at doing the nose. I'm starting to doubt my makeup skills through this video. And then finally, after I contour, I'll usually just take this light color and I'll kind of cut the contour a little bit. I haven't done my nose yet, but I'll do that after. I feel like I can't ever tell if my nose contour is good or not. We'll call that good. Next I go in with the Balm Frat Boy blush, and it is really, really good. It's like the best blush I've ever had. Right there, that's what it looks like. I'm not glaring you. I love the packaging too. It says so many men, so little time. I'm right above the contour. You just need a little bit to look great. Next part is the best. I'm gonna highlight the rest of my face. First to highlight, I go back in with Modern Renaissance palette, and I take the lightest shimmery shade, and I just kind of put that in the, like, the small areas. It's called Vermeer, I think. It is that lightest one right there. I just take Vermeer, and I put it kind of right in the corner with my eye. Try not to get it anywhere else. And then I put a little bit under my brow bone. Next, I take my favorite, which is my Glow Kit. And I go in with the one that's mostly gone. And I put that on every major, I put that on every like major highlighting area of my face. So that's like right up here. And just kind of swipe it up around. And the arch of my nose above my cupid's bow. And if that wasn't enough highlight, I go in with this Kat Von D Alchemist palette. And I use the pinkest color and kind of go over everything one more time. I feel like that just gives it a pink tone, makes it all tie the look together. But what more to tie the look together than lipstick? Alright, so this is ColourPop Satin Lip, and it is in the shade Magic Wand, and it is my favorite lipstick ever. I like the color, I like the feel. It's not completely matte, so it's still like, it's called Satin Lip for a reason, it looks like satin. So we're gonna do that, but first I put lip balm on my lips because my lips get really dry, especially in Colorado. So I'm gonna do that, and then I'm gonna put this lipstick on. And then the final thing to do is add some setting set blah, blah, blah. The final thing to do is add some setting spray. Wow, that was an experience. That was my video. I hope you guys liked it. Sorry about the sun. So yeah, if you guys enjoyed, please leave a like down below. Also, subscribe to our virtual pop star channel. So yeah, that concludes this tutorial. My hair looks like a hot mess right now. If you did like that, please like down below, comment, you know, the whole deal, and please subscribe to our virtual pop star channel. We are coming up with plenty of good ideas in the next coming months, so hopefully you guys can stick around to watch. If you want to apply to be on a YouTube team, you can do so by clicking the link down below. It'll just take you to an application. All we'll need to see is an example of your work along with like the whole application filled out. If you would like to do that, that would be wonderful. We really want new members, and even though we're not looking for vloggers right now, you can still apply to be one, and then we'll see what we need when it kind of get all the applications in. So you have a few more weeks to do that. I hope you guys apply and you like this video. Tell us what you want to see more of next. All right, bye.